my waist and put that body on me. I'm coming now, follow my lead. Come, coming now, follow my lead. I'm in love with the shape of you. We push and pull like a magnet do. Although my heart is falling too, I'm in love with your body. And last night you were
vibe right now, feel myself. Panda. I got broads in Atlanta. Just the lean in the family. Credit cards in the scammers. Hitting the licks in the van. Legacies, family. Wait and see, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana. Honey killers on the helmets. Legacies, family. Wait and see, panda. Pockets full, Danny. Selling ball, candy. Man on the macho like Randy. The chopper go out to for granted. This nigga bullet your banner. Hope killers on the standard. I got broads in Atlanta. Twisted the lean in the family. Credit cards in the scammers. Hitting the licks in the banner. Legacy, family. Way see, look like a panda. Going out like a Montana. Honey killers on the hammers. Legacy, family. Way see, family. Packers full, Danny. Selling ball, candy. Man on the macho like Randy. The chopper go out to for granted. Nigga pull up your banner. Hope the killers understand me.
Hey!
Panda. 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 Panda.
Hey everybody, welcome to another episode. Today's episode, I'm doing my 2017 Rod and Roll Arsenal video. I'd like to say, thanks to my team. I want a fishing team. We're sponsored by Dunkit. That's how I got most of my rods, and a few of my reels. So, yeah, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and get into it. Starting with my topwater rod. By topwater, I mean my frog rod. This is my Wright Miguel Insight Pro Advantage 7.2 jig and worm rod. I use it for my frog rod, but it's going to be switched to my, it's not going to be switched, but I'm going to switch it out for a Dunkit frog rod on probably a 7-foot Micromagic Pro or the Terex. So this reel is a Daiwa Tutula 7.3 ratio with 50 pound braid. This is Power Pro braid, by the way. So that's combo number one. Combo number two is my Dunkit Ghost XL rod. Had this since probably March of last year. Spooled with 10 pound test fluorocarbon. The Dunkit Ghost XL is 6'10" medium action, so it's a jerk, it's like my jerk bait and slash top water rod. I don't throw jerk baits all year, so that's when I switch it out for the top water. I do have to get a top water reel though, because I'm currently low on 7.1s. So this is an Ardent Elite bait casting reels. Like I said, spooled with 10 pound test. I think it's 6.4:1. What does it say? 6.5:1 is what it says. You know, pretty cool. I like the, definitely like the carbon fiber of the reel. So yeah, it's my jerkbait combo, but it soon will be my topwater combo. So moving on, got my next rod is the same Dunkit Ghost, 7-foot medium heavy, with a Daiwa Tutula 6.3:1, spooled with 15 pound test, and VizX, and this is, I got a chatterbait rigged up on this rod. Next rod is, I bought this probably July of 2016, ELX Icos Prime 7, so it's a 7-foot medium heavy. This is my swim jig rod. I don't have a reel for it right now. I try to use just my Dunkits. Next rod is another Ghost, 7-foot medium heavy. I'm not gonna pay attention to the rod. With my this reel was given to me. It's a Shimano Kronark 200D7, spooled with 15 pound fluorocarbon. It's not secret, by the way. The Tutula was 15 pound test in VizX. The Ardent was 10 pound test, red label. So yeah, there's that rod. Sorry, I got a mess. Alright, so next rod. This is my newest reel. I just bought it like 2 days ago. It bought a BB1. I didn't like it. So I took it back and got a new Daiwa. This is the Daiwa Tutuila CT63-1. So it's a little smaller than the regular Tutuilas. And this is on one of my cranking sticks. This cranking stick is the Duck It Ghost 7.6 cranking stick. As you see, I got a red rattle trap tied on. This was split with 15-pound bread label, fluorocarbon. So yeah, this reel is just an all-around reel. I just put it on my cranking stick for lipless crankbaits right now. So the next rod and reel is my deep cranking setup. But I only get to throw a deep crankbait when I'm on the boat on the tournament. Sorry. So this is my Duck It Terex 7.6 medium heavy cranking, same as that rod. Just this is the Terex. This reel is my Daiwa Zillion 5.5 to 1 gear ratio. Prove it's a zillion right there. Zillion. That's pulled with 12-pound test red label. I also have a lipless crankbait tied on. But like I said, it is going to be it is my deep diving rod. Deep diving crankbait rod. So this is my Berkeley Bionics rod. This was given to me by a friend. And this reel was also given to me by the same friend. This is a Fluger Intensity spinning reel. Spooled with 8-pound test fluorocarbon. It's a 5.2 gear ratio. And this rod, it's a 6.6 medium. It has a little bit of tip, so I can really throw this little rig I throw. It's a Dumiki, like it's a big bite bait shaky head, but it's, you can use it for Dumiki rig. What I do is I throw like a 3.5-inch swim bait. And I throw that around and just reel it, and I usually catch some fish on it. I'm either throwing the, I just got the cane thumpers by Big Light Baits, but I usually throw the reaction innovations, Little Dipper, I think is what it is. So my last rod is my Duck It Ghost 7-foot medium action spinning rod. This has an Arbor Garcia Aura S30, same friend gave me this reel. This is missing the little dial they gave to lock that reel handle in, but that's okay. I'm not really a big fan of Arbor Garcia. I hadn't fished with this reel much though, so I'm going to try it out more. But I probably will be upgrading the spinning reel to a dial spinning reel pretty soon, or a Fluger. This is for 8-pound test, red level fluorocarbon. The 7-foot medium ghost rod, it doesn't have enough flex in the tip to really throw that Dumiki rig. So right now I've got a Wacky Worm tied on, a Wacky Hook tied on. So I'll probably throw Wacky Worms with this and drop shots with this. So that's my arsenal, guys. Thanks for watching. I'm going to talk a little bit longer. This is the 3rd of March. The 4th of March, I'm heading to Monster Jam with a friend, so that's why I'm recording this video a day ahead. And I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to post it exactly at 5 o'clock, so keep your eyes open. Then the 9th through the 12th of March, I'm going to be gone at Winterfest 2017. And I don't know about the Wi-Fi situation up there. Last year was pretty terrible. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to post a video next week. But I will be recording a tourney prep video coming up afterwards. Because I have a tournament on Lake Lanier March 19th. So I will have a tourney prep video. And then if I do catch a fish or we have a good tournament, I will probably do a tournament vlog. It's only a one-day tournament, but why not? That'll be posted after the 19th, both videos. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Comment, rate, subscribe. I will be getting more rods and reels before the end of the year for sure. I know I'll be upgrading my frog rod, so maybe a Falcon or a Duck It, probably a Duck It though. I am getting another Daiwa reel. They have the rebate going on when you can get a free shirt, so that's what I'm doing. I'm probably going to try to get the tactical one left 8.1 to 1 gear ratio. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching, and comment, rate, subscribe, go check out my Instagram page, and tight lines, guys. Peace out.